letter into the mailbox with no return address. She backed away from what she'd done, smiled at the emptiness.
Suki slipped back in the driver's seat, looked in the rearview mirror. Remorse, regret, she turned the key reverse, but no return. Starting over, starting over, starting over, starting over.
She felt a hunger in her belly and her foot down on the gas. The cry of the road, the growling in her belly made her drive too fast. Static on the radio, starting over, starting over.
Suki smelled the coffee burning as she walked into the place. The waiter didn't like her, she could see it in his face.
And he said to her, you know, if you don't like the coffee in here, why don't you go get back in your little car and go on down the road? Because I'm sure you can find yourself some nice little coffee shop somewhere that'll give you a little latte or espresso or something with whipped cream and a cherry on top. It's a big world out there. Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
And she thought to herself, you know what? He's right. It's a big, big world out there. As big as the Blue Pacific or that Cracker's Cadillac in Tampa Bay or the Sequoias in California. As big as Chicago traffic. Or those power towers marching across Elizabeth, New Jersey. As big as her vacant womb.
Suki drove for hours, for days, for weeks, between the broken lines. She drove by the water, she drove by